Hello students, today we will discuss on logic gates. Logic gate is an electronic circuit having two or more inputs but only one output. The output is having certain relation with the input and it is given by mathematical equation and called as Boolean equation. These logic gates works on logic levels. The logic levels are high and low, 0 and 1. There are two types of logic systems used. One is called as positive logic and another is negative logic. In positive logic system, logic 0 is represented by low voltage level and logic 1 by high voltage level. That is, more positive voltage is considered as logic 1 and the more negative logic as 0. The positive logic system is widely used. Second, in negative logic system, logic 0 is represented by high voltage level and logic 1 by low logic level, that is more positive voltage, is treated as logic 0. Now back to logic gates. There are three types of basic gates used in logic gates. The first one is the NOT gate. It has only one input and only one output. If A is considered as an input, output is given by Boolean equation Y equal to A complement. This logic circuit of NOT gate can be constructed by using a simple common emitter transistor circuit as shown in the figure. Since there is one input, there will be only two possibilities of the input. See in the diagram, you can see that there is a transistor which is connected in common emitter configuration. A resistor RC, it is connected with positive power supply. A resistor RB is connected at the base of the transistor. Now in common emitter amplifier, if the base voltage is high enough to forward bias the diode between base and emitter, then transistor will be turned on. If the voltage across the base is 0, then this transistor will be off. So here only two possibilities of inputs are there. So if logic 0 is connected at the input of base, then transistor will be off. Since there is the path from collector to emitter will be off, that is the transistor is off, therefore voltage drop across resistor RC will be high. Hence at the Y output we will get high voltage. So here at the base we have connected logic 0 and we are getting logic high at the output. Second condition, if it is connected to logic high, that means the base of the transistor will have high voltage. So here base to emitter voltage will be more enough to forward bias the diode between base to emitter. The transistor will be on. If the transistor is on, the current from the positive supply towards ground, that path will be on. No current will drop across resistor RC. Hence, the voltage across RC will be 0. So here, if logic 1 is connected, we are getting 0 at the output. So in this way, this circuit will behave like a NOT gate. So NOT gate is used to complement the inputs. Second gate is the OR gate. It can have two or more inputs and a single output. If we consider A and B are the two input variables, the output is given by the Boolean equation Y equal to A plus B. OR gate is used for addition of the inputs. This logic circuit of OR gate can be constructed by using diodes and resistor as shown in the figure. Here two diodes are connected, one to input A and one to input B. Output is taken at the common cathode with a passive pull-up resistor with respect to ground. So here two inputs are there, and if binary levels are to be applied, there will be four combinations are possible. First of all, let us see if A and B both are low, both the diodes will be in reverse bias. So here at the output we will get 0. If one of the diode is connected to plus VCC, then one of the diode will be forward bias and the output will be 1. Similarly, if both the inputs are high, both the diodes will be forward bias and we will get high at the output. So here from the truth table you can see both are low, output will be 0. If one of the diode is forward bias or both of the diodes are forward bias, we will get high output. We can define it as either or both the inputs are high, the output is high. Now the third gate is the AND gate. It also has two or more inputs but only one output. If A and B are the variable used as inputs, the output is given by Boolean equation Y equal to A dot B. So here AND gate is used for multiplications of binary inputs. The logic circuit of AND gate can be constructed using two diodes and resistor as shown in the figure. From the circuit you can see there are two diodes connected to inputs A and B. Their anodes are common and output is taken across the anode and the ground. There are two inputs and there will be four possibilities. If A equal to B equal to 1, both the diodes conduct through A and B due to forward bias and due to which all the current from the power supply will move towards ground. So no current at the output, so the output voltage will be 0. case second, if A equal to 0 and B equal to 1. Now input A is connected to ground. That is why this diode will be forward bias and it will conduct towards ground through input A, which will again make the Y output to ground potential. So here Y equal to 0. Case third, if A equal to 1, B equal to 0, now input B will be forward bias and the power supply's positive terminal, the current will flow towards ground through input B, making Y output to ground potential. So here also the output Y equal to 0. In fourth case, if A equal to 1, B equal to 1, now in this case both the diodes will be reverse biased and will not conduct. So due to which all the current from the power supply will go to the output and here output will be high, making Y equal to 1. Here we can define it as for AND gate, when both A and B are high, the output is high. Now after basic gates, there are some gates which are modified or constructed using the basic gates. So these gates are called as derived gates or modified gates. There are three types of modified gates: NAND gate, NOR gate and XOR gate. First of all, let us see NAND gate. NAND gate is constructed using a AND gate and a NOT gate. AND gate is connected first and then NOT gate is connected. The symbol is shown here also. If binary levels are to be applied, four possible combinations will be there. First of all, let us see if both the inputs are 0, their multiplication is done by first AND gate. So here 0 multiplied by 0 it will be 0 and this 0 will be inverted by NOT gate, the output will be 1. In second case, if one of the input is 0 and one of the input is high, AND gate will give 0 output. Again, this 0 is complemented by NOT gate, so output will be 1. Again, if one of the input is high and one of the input is 0, again multiplication will be 0. So AND gate will output 0 and this 0 is complemented by NOT gate. So here we will get high output. Fourth case, if both the inputs are high, then this multiplication will be done by an AND gate. We will get high at the output and this high is inverted by the NOT gate and we will get 0 outputs. We can define it when one or all the inputs of NAND gate is low, the output is high. The second gate in derived gate is the NOR gate. NOR gate is constructed using OR gate and a NOT gate. First OR gate is connected, then its output is given to NOT gate. So here four possible combinations are there. So if both the inputs are 0, that means A equal to 0, B equal to 0, it is ORed by the OR gate. So 0 plus 0 is 0 and 0 is inverted by NOT gate and we will get 1 at the output. Second condition, if A is connected to 0 and B is connected to 1, 0 plus 1 OR will give the output 1 and this 1 is complemented by NOT gate and we will get 0 at the output. Similarly, if A is connected to 1, B is connected to 0, OR gate will give the output 1 and this 1 is complemented by the NOT gate and we will get 0 at the output. Lastly, if both the inputs are high, 1 plus 1 is done by OR gate and output will be 1. 1 is complemented by NOT gate and we will get 0 at the output. So we can define it when all the inputs of NOR gate is low, the output is high. Now the last derived gate is the XOR gate. Two or more inputs are there, but it has only one output. The Boolean equation of XOR gate is represented by Y equal to A complement dot B plus A dot B complement. So Y equal to A XOR B. This XOR sign is nothing but a N circle plus sign. This gate can be constructed using the combination of AND gate, OR gate and NOT gate. From the Boolean equation, we can construct the logic diagram as first is the product in which A is the complement. So for complement, A is connected to NOT gate. This NOT gate's output and B is multiplied here and we will get A complement dot B at first AND gate. For the second product, A is directly connected to the AND gate and B is complemented. So here A dot B complemented will be given by the second AND gate. Outputs of both the AND gates are connected to OR gate. Addition of A complement dot B and A dot B complement will be done by the last OR gate and we will get A XOR B at the output. Here two input XOR gate is shown. There are four possibilities. If A is connected to 0 and B is also connected to 0, the output Y will be given by putting these values in the Boolean equation. Y equal to 0 complement dot 0 plus 0 dot 0 complement. First product will be 1 into 0 and second product will be 0 into 1. So 1 into 0 equal to 0 and 0 into 1 is also equal to 0. So at the last 0 plus 0 will be equal to 0. Second combination is A equal to 0 and B equal to 1. Then the output will be 0 complement dot 1 plus 0 dot 1 complement. 0 complement dot 1 will be 1 into 1 and 0.1 complement will be 0 into 0. So at the output 1 into 1 is 1, 0 into 0 is 0. So 1 plus 0 will be equal to 1. Third combination will be A equal to 1, B equal to 0. The output will be given as 1 complement dot 0 plus 1 dot 0 complement. So 1 complement will be 0 and second 0 it is multiplied. So 0 into 0 plus 1 into 1. So here 0 plus 1 will be 1. So output will be 1. If both the inputs are high, then the combination at the Boolean equation will be 1 complement dot 1 plus 1 dot 1 complement. So here output will be 0 into 1 plus 1 into 0. So at the output 0 plus 0 output will be 0. So here we can define this OR gate as for odd number of high inputs the output is high.